Recently, a Republican lawmaker in the state of Missouri was forced to resign after a jury convicted her on 22 different counts, all related to fraud, to a medical clinic that she ran while also being an elected official in the state. So that's a little weird, right? That we allow that to happen. I'll get more to that in a moment. But let's talk about the crimes that this individual committed. Of course, this was Missouri State Representative Trisha Dergs, who got $900,000 from the CARES Act to distribute tests via a nonprofit that she ran. But she didn't actually use the $900,000 to provide any free tests for anyone. What she did instead was she funneled the money to her for-profit medical clinic. So she got almost $1 million from the CARES Act, you know, the COVID funds, said, I've got this nonprofit over here. We're going to give out free tests. We're going to do all the right things because we love people so much. So they said, well, sure, heck yeah, here's your money. And then she said, ha suckers, I'm going to stick it into my for-profit medical clinic that I'm running, again, while still being a state lawmaker. And then, boom, massive profit for me, right? Well, she got busted. And now she's going to jail for a very long time. Because, you see, she wasn't only found guilty of defrauding the government for, you know, misusing those COVID funds. She was also found guilty of, let me read it, because this is so ridiculous. The jury convicted Dergs on another 7 counts of wire fraud for charging patients a combined amount of nearly $200,000 for what she fraudulently marketed as a stem cell treatment at her for-profit clinic. The jury additionally found her guilty on 2 counts of making false statements for telling federal agents the treatment contained stem cells when she knew it did not, in addition to other untrue information. The jury also found Dergs guilty of 10 counts of illegally providing drugs over the internet without a valid prescription. Jesus Christ. All while being a state representative. Now, I know working in a state legislature is not like working in Congress, okay? You've got much better hours. I mean, as little as Congress actually works, you know, all the recesses they get, you know, the weeks upon weeks upon weeks when Americans literally get a day off, it's even less for state lawmakers. And of course, the pay is not as good as what you get in DC. Nevertheless, this individual shouldn't have been allowed to run a for-profit business while serving as an elected leader for the state. We have got to do something about this. Not just about the criminal activity of it, because clearly that's been handled with this individual. You know, Ms. Dergs is going away for a very long time. But the problem is the conflicts of interest that arise. You should not be allowed to own a business if you're an elected official. You just shouldn't. Maybe city council, something like that. Yes, I understand. That's not a full-time job. But if you're an elected official that gets a yearly salary and you make laws, you shouldn't be allowed to own a business. I don't care if it's at the state level, the federal level, whatever it is. We got to do something to clean this up, because until we do, we're going to get more ridiculous stories like this of individuals using federal funds to line their own pockets. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.